A system that helped destroy the chemical agent stockpile in Alabama several years ago is taking on a new mission beginning in 2016.
Anniston Field Office has two basic roles. One is to oversee the operations of the static detonation chamber.
The static detonation chamber, or SDC, will support operations at ACWA's two pilot plants.
And two is to provide assistance upon request from the Bluegrass facility as well as the Pueblo facility.
The Anniston Army Depot once stored approximately 7% of the original U.S. chemical weapons stockpile. Tim GARRETT led the team that completed chemical weapons disposal operations in 2011.
People who went through the construction, startup, systemization, and actual operations and subsequent closure of the Anniston Chemical Agent Disposal Facility, that translates very well into supporting, you know, the ACWA program.
Anniston's SDC augmented destruction operations at the site's main facility by destroying problematic munitions.
The static detonation chamber that was implemented here was the first of a kind in the United States.
Today, GARRETT oversees the Anniston Field Office, which will use the same SDC to destroy Pueblo's energetic parts. Here's how the process will work. In 2016, a pilot plant in Colorado will begin to neutralize Pueblo's chemical agent stockpile. As part of that process, munitions will be disassembled, separating the energetics from the mustard agent-filled munition bodies. The chemical agent will be destroyed on-site in Colorado. However, the bursters, fuses, and other energetic parts, confirmed to be non-contaminated, will be transferred more than 1,200 miles east to Anniston for disposal.
All of the energetics that we're shipping to Anniston will be put into what we call purpose-built packaging. And this packaging has to meet the requirements of the Department of Transportation, DOT regulations.
The Pueblo and Anniston teams have been coordinating plans and procedures for months in preparation of operations at both sites.
We've developed a strong working relationship with the team down at Anniston. They're experienced in the processing of energetics, and they've processed many already that are very similar to the ones that we're going to ship them.
Once the energetics arrive at Anniston, they'll be stored.
We store them in one of our three service magazines.
From here, the parts will be transferred to a loading area, manually placed into trays, and then fed onto conveyors.
Everything at that point is controlled remotely from our control room to minimize the risk to personnel.
Then the energetics will be loaded into the SDC.
That's our detonation chamber,
which can be heated up to 1100 degrees Fahrenheit. At this point, the scrap is demilitarized.
A lot of the scrap that you'll see coming out behind us will be over 700 degrees. The scrap is conveyed down to the observation window, at which point we have two operators that will verify the scrap has been demilitarized.
Using the SDC's thermal destruction technology, the Anniston team has a proven track record.
We have processed over 100,000 munitions or energetic components through the detonation chamber.
That experience not only benefits the Pueblo plant, but also the Bluegrass plant in Kentucky, which is building its own static detonation chamber to destroy the Bluegrass mustard agent stockpile. The Anniston team provides a program with experience, including employees who completed the Anniston mission from start to finish.
I watched it being built from the ground up. I watched them destroy all the munitions. I was instrumental in the closure of the facility, and now I feel like I've got the experience and knowledge to help Bluegrass and Pueblo to complete their missions.
GARRETT says that legacy knowledge is a benefit for both the Pueblo and Bluegrass plants.
It's a tremendous advantage that they have in being able to incorporate safety lessons, operational lessons, environmental lessons from the place that, you know, originally did it, which was here at Anniston.
With the Anniston chemical agent stockpile safely destroyed, the Alabama team is prepped and ready to support ACWA's future operations.